Good afternoon and welcome to Cornell Gymnasium on the campus of Creed Farms and Badger. This afternoon we feature you in the front yard basketball matchup between the Hotchkiss School Bearcats and your Greens Farms Cafe Dragons. And now time to introduce today's starting lineups first for the visiting Hotchkiss School Bearcats, coached by Doug Nealon and Eileen Sullivan. Number 5, Kayla Richard. Number 10, Angel Allen. Number 14, Grace Backus. Number 15, Morgan Jenkins. And number 21, Lexi Clark. And now for your Greens Farms Academy Dragons, coached by Maria Conlon, Lamar Mayo, Stacey Nasser, and Connor Charnick. Number 14, first year, Lala Good. Number 5, sophomore, London Powell. Number 30, junior, Cheyenne Brand. Number 33, junior, Riley Tate Pinion. And number 10, senior, Captain Molly Beardley.
Welcome to GSPN. I'm Jared Lessing here with my co-host Brendan Shanahan. Today, we're bringing you a matchup between GFA Girls Varsity Basketball and Hotchkiss. We should be treated with a great matchup here today, Brendan. We're having a doubleheader, the boys game against King Referral and Peter Hill's tip-off.
As Hotchkiss wins the tip, number 5 driving.
And number 5, Taylor Richards, immediately gets him off to a hot start.
Jared, that's the bucket in the first 3 seconds of the game. I'm excited to see how this game goes with that change of energy. And Raya Zatadian looking for Lala Good. Can't find her. And Jared, I mean, Hotchkiss stops it. Quick start right out of the gate for this game. See a quick layup and quick turnover there. See how they can bounce back off of that.
Back to number 5, Taylor Richards on the wing. And can't get it to fall. That was number 15. And there they get it to go from mid-range to jumper.
Angel.
Hotchkiss off to a hot start here, Brennan. 4-0 so far.
GFA breaking the Hotchkiss press here. Powell finds Tay-Pady in the corner. Tay-Pady taking her time here. GFA is looking to slow the offense down. And a good move from Powell with a little spin on the ground. Oh, it gets nailed in the face by her own teammate. Number 5, Kelly Richards controlling the offense. Finds number 21 in the corner. Gets it to go. That is Lexi Clark with the 3.
A great bucket there. They found her in the corner running. That was a really good look. Good one to get to go. Now it's London Powell bringing it back up for GFA. Number 5. Looks for Molly Keaveney. Number 10 in the corner. The lone starter in the starting line, I was going to say a lone senior, but that's not true. As Lila Good can't get it to fall, but rebounded by Tay-Padian, and fouled as she goes up.
As Tay-Padian will shoot for 2. I mean, Jared, Seven.
Hotchkiss foul on
seven up start early in this game for Hotchkiss. I mean, they
shooting right like they did.
I mean, so that layup right off the tip.
As Tate Padian gets the first one. Hotchkiss came out right away, got the tip, immediately got a bucket in the way. Came back to the mid-range, and then a three. And they got up to a 7-0 start to start the game. I mean, you want to see them stay aggressive as number 15 gets the rebound there. That's Angel Allen with it, passes to Taylor Richards. Richards driving. And blocked as she goes up by GFA. Look to like Lara. They got her on the way up.
They did. I mean, that was a good look, though, from Taylor Richards. That was a good drive, but I didn't catch who blocked her, but whoever it was a pretty good block.
And Angel Allen will be in down of the ball for them here. Clark gave it to back. It's back to Clark. To Allen. In and out. Rebounded by Padian, but tipped away. Gotten by Richard. She backs it out, slows it down. Looking to create something here. Clark. Richards from three. Got it to go, Brendan.
I mean, Jared, that is a quick in. GFA coming on. They're going to regroup and re-strategize here. I mean, Jared, 10-1 start early in this first quarter. I mean, GFA's going to find something to bounce back from this early deficit. I mean, Jared, there's nothing more describing that than just they came out swinging. I mean, like, literally since the tip-off, Hotchkiss just brought more energy and then more aggressive. They've been forcing turnovers and they're making their shots. GFA's maybe shot two or three times. Hotchkiss has shot four or five, and I think all of them. Maybe missed one, but
I mean, as a team, if you come out really aggressive and you're taking a lot of shots, it's just making it hard, and you're scoring in different ways. It just makes it harder for GFA to guard you. They're putting themselves in a position to get open looks, and they're being aggressive on the glass, trying to get steals, force turnovers, and it's been working for them so far. They've got a 9-point lead early on here. GFA will look to respond here. Allen guarding them on the front court. It's a London foul bringing it up. Pushing the pace out to Keithney from three. And can't get it to go. Looking to respond there, but couldn't get it to fall. A good look there, though. She's a great shooter, Brendan. We talked about it on our last broadcast for the girls. She broke the school record last year with 10 three-pointers in a game. And you want to see her take as many threes as she can.
You do. I mean, Jared, 30 points off threes in a single game is practically unheard of in any level of basketball. Between now high school is even more impressive.
As Clark couldn't get that one to fall.
In and out, Jared. That would have been a real heartbreaker if that went in.
Tate Padian pulls up from mid-range. Got it to fall. A smooth jumper there, Brendan.
And I mean, Jared, Tate Padian is also a very well-rounded player, but a great shooter for the GFA team. And I see on her left wrist, she has a little cast restriction.
As Backus gets a three. Jared, to a 10-point lead.
I'm wondering if Tate Padian is fighting some resistance right now, and if she can, if it's going to affect her shooting or her play in general. But right now, I mean, missed a free throw, but besides that, has been playing very well, and we'll see for the rest of the game.
Keezy scrambling, looking for any option. Ball's being batted around. Tadian on the floor with it. Jump ball called.
Keezy kind of lost there, Jared. It's kind of a wild pass from Lee Powell. And then Keezy's going to get her hands on it. And now the jump ball, but it will stay with GFA.
As Maddie DiNatale checks in for Molly Keezy there. GFA looking to chip away at this 10-point deficit early on.
And that was a good look from Cheyenne Brand there. Down low. Found Powell. Powell.
Foul. Shooting London Powell.
And got the first one to fall. And can't get the second one to fall. GFA, she's looking to respond here.
Tay Petty from behind has a good four post, but cannot retain possession.
Lexi Clark, pump faking, guarded by DiNatale and Powell. GFA, aggressive on defense here. And Kayla Richards. couldn't get it to fall. It hit off the glass, then the backboard. Rebounded by DiNatale. GFA pushing the pace here. Brand with it. Out to the corner. Powell driving. And a smooth move, but blocked.
I mean, Joe, that was a good move from Powell. She went off that screen. Hit a little crossover to the right hand. Got by a defender.
And that was Morgan Jenkins on the block.
I mean, Jared. She seems like a defensive presence. I mean, that block right there sent that packing shot from Powell. And I mean, I almost say she's the biggest player on the court. So, well, I'm looking to see, as Cheyenne Brand makes her left-hand layup.
A smooth make there, Renna.
I'm looking forward to that balance between Brand and Jenkins down low there. The two biggest players in the court. Both two, I'm sure, very, very good players. Excited to see their matchup as this game goes forward.
As Hotchkiss can't get it to fall. That was number 22, Eleanor Helm. Subbed into the game recently. That was her first shot. Could not get it to fall. Hit off the rim. GFA trying to chip away at a 7-point deficit here. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left to go in this first quarter. Powell with it, crossing half court. She's been getting guarding really aggressively so far. She's doing a good job handling the pressure, though.
She has here, and that'll be a jump ball going to Hoskins' way. But, Jared, I mean, as you watch a couple of the games so far, you know London Powell is a very strong player. She, is one of the commanders of this GFA offense. And Hoskins is doing a good job of shutting her down early, trying to kill the momentum that GFA is going for.
As it's stolen by GFA, DiNatale pushes the pace. Trying to sneak through the contact. Got hit as she went up, but didn't get a foul call.
I mean, Jared,
Taylor
Richards will
take it the other way. And pulls up for mid-range, but couldn't get it to fall. Rebounded by Hotchkiss, though. Number 10, Angel Allen. On the fadeaway, couldn't get it to fall. Lala good. To Brand. Underneath. Got the foul call. Couldn't get the and one, though.
And Jared, as I was saying before, Jenkins there. Another block shot. She just fouled Cheyenne Brand. GFA looked like... Sorry about that. GFA looked to get Jenkins in foul trouble early because, I mean, you can see she's a presence in the paint. And Jenkins, we've seen, they love to operate around the paint and around the three-point line. So getting Jenkins, as Brand makes one, getting Jenkins in foul trouble early will be key to GFA doing this game.
As Brand knocks down both free throws, brings it to a 5-point game. Just over 3 minutes left to go here in the first quarter. Richards with it. Back to Allen. Good ball movement here from Hotchkiss. But it's stolen by GFA. Powell going the other way. She's got 3 options. And they can't get the free to fall. That was Tate Padian. GFA will keep possession, though.
Thank you, GFA.
Powell inbounding for GFA.
Maddie sizing up her defender.
Working under the basket.
I believe she lost it, and the Hotchkiss defender stepped out of bounds as she got possession. Unfortunate for Hotchkiss there. It'll stay with GFA. Brandon inbounding.
And got it out to Powell. Powell looking to create something here. Gets it to Brand. Tate Padian again from 3. And off the rim, but tipped out. Going the other way. GFA bench looking unhappy about it. Hit on that pressure. Tough to see from our angle, Brenda.
I mean, Jared, there, Tate Padian with 2 threes. Couldn't give him the fall, but knowing her confidence, she will keep on shooting. And I believe that shot will fall at some point in this game.
Richards brought it up for them. Back with it, driving. And it's stolen again. Lala good. And a foul called. This GFA bench and fans getting excited here. As Molly Keaveney subs in for Tate Payton. Number 11, Macy Wright. Checks in for Kayla Richards.
Re-entering the game for GFA, Molly Keaton.
As we're seeing the stands back up here in the little gym.
Powell working. As Brand dove on it. Jump ball called, it'll stay.
I mean, Jared, early in this game, early in the first quarter, we've seen three jump balls and maybe four turnovers. I mean, both teams have to limit the turnovers if they want to win this game. Turnovers are a big part of basketball, and limiting them is key to success.
And both teams have been super aggressive on the ball, trying to force steals first.
Yeah, but I mean, you see Hotchkiss right now double-teaming and trapping the ball up top. That's a very aggressive defensive style.
Called for a jump ball.
That was a jump ball. I didn't see that one, Jared. But, I mean, Hotchkiss pressed whoever had the ball at half court. Very aggressive defensive style. And, you know, higher Kyler Ward is working right now. They have the lead. Legit, they can find a way to break that press.
We're talking about GFA, a team that thrives in motion and ball moving around them.
Exactly.
They're trying to create open shots, and they're trying to make it as difficult as possible for them to move around and get the best passes they can.
Exactly, Jared. I mean, the best way to break a press is to keep the ball moving. You know, as a basketball player myself, I know that whenever you're getting pressed, you want to keep that ball. You don't want to keep it in corners, and you don't want to keep it in the same person's hand. You want to pass the ball. GFA look to do that.
As Keefney can't get it to fall from three, and it's rebounded by Hotchkiss. Number 22, Helm, winning that pass to three. Allen, off the mark.
Powell for three, could not get it to go. Good look.
And rebounded by Lala, good. But Keeney couldn't get it. It's going to stay GFA ball, though, as it's tipped out of bounds. And a good rebound there by Lala, good. Good
gap for Hotchkiss.
And they get it into Brand.
I mean, Jared, look at this press. I mean, they're just letting GFA have it. That's a Brand. Good move,
Brand
there.
Knocks it down from mid-range.
That was the only from Brand. I mean, this press is hurting Giovanna. I know they cut the speed down, but you can see them struggling on this Hotchkiss press.
As Helm let it go from three and couldn't get it to fall. And they couldn't get the putback. That was Jenkins. And then a foul called.
That's the second foul Jenkins, Jared. That's two in this first quarter.
A 7-point lead, Brennan, at 7-0. And now we're looking at a 13-10 game. GFA, a good job. Get their way back into this one. I mean, if you're Hotchkiss, you've got to be thinking you still have a lead, and you need to continue to do whatever you can to build on that.
I mean, yeah, Jared, I agree with you. I just think that Hotchkiss is shooting up. I think it's going to this game. They had an early start. Hotchkiss came out striking early, and then GFA retaliated back. As Keeney hits both and cuts C down the line. Now, I mean, Jared, you're playing this game after a new team has 0-0. I mean, new strategies, new game plans. No one has an edge in this game right now.
Richards trying to penetrate GFA D. Allen with it, crossing, driving. Gets the foul call. She's going to get two from the line. Chance to make it a 3-point game.
Jared, it is loud in this gym. I mean, I know you're hearing it. The GFA bench and just the crowd in general is just very noisy atmosphere. And I'm wondering how it's affecting Hotchkiss as the away team.
GFA ball, number 30, Cheyenne Brand, her first. She's first.
Checking for Powell after. A little disagreement here from the ref and the coaches.
Entering the game for GFA,
Powell.
Shooting Angel Allen.
And Allen can't get the first one to fall. Just over 30 seconds left to go here in this first quarter. 1-point game. And Allen knocks down the second one. Brings their point to 14. Kate Payton will bring it up. She just checked back in the game for London Powell. Looks like they're going to keep maintaining that press. Kate Payton with it. Got it to Keefney. Pump fakes. To Brent. Good ball movement here from GFA. Pinatale. Pump fake. And floater, but couldn't get it to fall. Hotchkiss keeps it in and gets it to Kayla Richards. She's going to push the floor, try to take it all the way.
Allen, an off balance through there. Not the best look. As the quarters end, 12 to 14 with the Hotchkiss lead. I mean, Jared's been back in the game. He's had Hotchkiss come out early with a big 10-point lead, 9-point lead. Then GFA came back, now only down 2. I mean, very good first quarter there. Kind of sloppy though, Jerry. I mean, a lot of turnovers, a lot of jump balls. And, you know, as I said before, turnovers are a big part of basketball, and when you limit them is when you win games. So both teams will look to slow the ball. But, I mean, the Hotchkiss press, Jared, is really messing with GFA. GFA's having a hard time slowing the ball, looking for open teammates, finding open cuts, because Hotchkiss is just letting them have it. And that's the point of a press. You know, you don't let the opponent breathe. You know, like a boa constrictor. You just choke them out, scare them. And I'd say, I mean, they did come back from a big deficit, but I feel like the press is pretty effective right now against GFA. So GFA will need to find a way to break this press consistently and not have turnovers.
Yeah, definitely something to look for going into the second quarter. I mean, turn the ball over probably 3 to 5 times that quarter, and that's a lot for one quarter. I mean,
that
I'd love to see them make some adjustments, try to see what they can do to handle that press from Hotchkiss, which, like you said, is making them really uncomfortable, making it really difficult for them to get passes off, difficult to get open looks. Powell set back in the game. She's bringing it up. Brand with it now. 80 in from 3. And in and out. But a rebound, put back, and tied the game. Great job by GFI there. London Powell to get the offensive rebound and put back. As Richards tries to float it off the glass and couldn't, but a rebounded by herself and couldn't get it to fall again the second time. Powell bringing it up now after Lowell got the rebound.
Tay Payton misses that one. I mean, as I said before, the shot isn't falling for Tay Payton right now, but she will keep on shooting. She's a confident player. And I do believe sometime during the second quarter that shot will start to fall.
Richards with it. Screen coming from Smith. She rolls, but Richards doesn't want it. Going by herself. Called for a travel.
Travel with Richards, Garrett. Well, I think Kayla Richards is doing a very good job of controlling this offense for Hotchkiss. I mean, as you can see...
As good couldn't get that one to fall. I mean, she's just been attacking all game, just driving every possession she's had. As good fell short of out of the basket there. Hotchkiss. And number 5, Taylor Richards, we were just talking about her, gets that one to go off the glass. Transition there to set herself up. Got an open look. Tay Payton searching for something here. Hit Brand. Powell couldn't get it to fall. Richards all over the court right now, Brendan. And Allen can't hold on to the ball. It was rebounded by Smith. Kick back to Richards. Driving. Calls for another travel.
Re-entering the game for Hotchkiss, Grace Backus, Virginia Faye.
Chopping her feet a little bit, making a little one too many steps. Trying to almost go over the GFA defender with her arms, you could see. Couldn't get it to work there. We'll see if she keeps going back to that move. She's tried it about twice here, but she just did get something. Powell with it. Brand. Tay Payton looking down low, and it's stolen. Richards couldn't get it to fall, but it was rebounded and put back up.
Good Re-entering the game for Hotchkiss, Morgan Jenkins.
We're going GFA way now. Down four. Powell and Vanity. And Keevney called through on now. I mean, we talked about this in the first game today, Brendan. A lot of travel calls, a lot of carry calls, which you don't see too often in basketball at this point in time. I don't know, three called in just a couple minutes here so far this game. Interesting to see if that will come into play. I mean, we're talking a lot about turnovers, and that's a free turnover that you're giving the other team. And that's just a waste of a possession. So both teams going to look to limit that. As Helm couldn't get it to fall, and it's rebounded by Brand, going the other way, pushing the pace. Looking for Brand again, coming around. Dina Tully back into Brand, outside, Keevney from three. Got it to go! Helm back with it. Tipped away, Powell. Gets the steal and then a foul called.
Hotchkiss foul number 22, Eleanor Helm, her first team's first score. Re-entering the game for Hotchkiss, Angel Allen.
And Keevney gets another one, gives them a lead. And Hotchkiss looking to respond there. Couldn't get it to fall. Like, couldn't get the putback either. GFA gets the rebound, going to the right. Keevney with it. Poked away by Allen. But Keevney recovers. Dribbling. And a foul called. It'll be going for GFA again. Looking to build on the now 3-point lead. Their first of the game.
Hotchkiss foul number 5, Kayla Richards, her second. Team second of the quarter.
Powell with it. Looking to create here for GFA. Down to Dina Tully. Couldn't get it off the rim. Rebounded by Hotchkiss. Allen has it. Controls her dribble after losing it for a little bit. To the corner. Backus. Hit Jenkins, and Jenkins gets it to rattle in. She ties the game.
Morgan Jenkins.
As that's tipped away and stolen by Jenkins. Going the other way. Gives it to Richards. She's been orchestrating the offense all day so far. She's been doing a great job. Allen with it. Crossing. Working at her defenders. And Backus couldn't get it to fall. But rebounded by Richards. And gets it to fall. Back and forth game running. We just saw a couple of changes. And it's a 2-point lead here for Hotchkiss. Just under 3 minutes here to go in this half. Brand from three. Couldn't get it to fall. Like to see that look there. A lot of confidence. She took that shot. Down two. Couldn't get it to fall. Richards spins. Ball's poked away, but she recovers it. Jenkins, pump fake. Driving in. Allen. To Backus. In and out. It'll stay with Hotchkiss.
Stays with Hotchkiss. Re-entering the game for GFA, Lala Miller. Timeout, GFA, 30-second timeout. Thank you. Traveling GFA ball. Technical foul called on Hotchkiss. That is Hotchkiss' third team foul of the quarter. Shooting Mamakiki. GFA foul on Cheyenne Grant, her second team's first in the quarter. Shooting Morgan Jenkins. GFA foul on Lila Good, her first team, second of the quarter. Hotchkiss foul on number 5, Kayla Richards. Her third team's fourth. Oh! Illegal dribble, Hotchkiss ball. Your score after one half, GFA 26, Hotchkiss 26. Hotchkiss foul, number 10, Angel Holland, her second team, third. Held ball, Aaron Hotchkiss. Hotchkiss foul on Leighton Smith, her third, team's fourth. Hotchkiss ball. GFA foul on Molly Keaton, her first, team second. Re-entering the game for Hotchkiss, Morgan Jenkins. Travelers, Hotchkiss ball. Hotchkiss foul on Kayla Richards, her fifth. Team's fifth. Shooting Molly Keeney. This full timeout. GFA ball. Timeout, Hotchkiss. 30-second timeout. Re-entering the game for Hotchkiss, Daisy Wright. Thank you. Copyright. GFA ball. Re-entering the game for Hotchkiss, Angel Allen and Layton Smith. Hotchkiss ball. Re-entering the game for Hotchkiss, Morgan Jenkins. Held ball, possession error to Hotchkiss. Correction, GFA ball. Timeout, GFA. Timeout, GFA, full timeout. Team's fifth. Shooting Morgan Jenkins. GFA foul on Riley Tate Patey in her first, team sixth. Shooting Morgan Jenkins. Thank you. Angel Allen. Today's final score, Hotchkiss 56, GFA 47. Stay tuned for the second half of today's basketball doubleheader as Boys Varsity Basketball takes on the King School, starting in approximately 20 minutes. Thank you.
Tripping out.